guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 9 and 10 of Sleepy Princess in the Demon Castle, so let's go ahead and get started. Episode 9, and 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, she watched the TV! I look like a waterbed, but a little more like slime. Yeah, it's a waterbed! Hey, will you learn something new? You need a phone. Is that a phone? It's a phone. What's the address? Seriously? Hang on. Oh my God! Yeah, you're right. I mean, but all she wants now is a waterbed. Guys, you can make that. That's easy. No, but you see, he doesn't want to ignore it. They got a quest. Stop. How the hell are you gonna make a waterbed, though? I mean, you're gonna need water, of course, but, like a rubbery mattress material. I don't know how the heck she can make that. Like, I've only slept on a waterbed one time, and my uncle had one. And my parents and I were on our way to Philadelphia, so we stopped at my uncle's house, and, like, I slept on it. It's a... interesting experience to sleep on one, but it still feels weird. Like, my bed is comfortable as heck. The bed I had before this mattress was comfortable as heck too, but this mattress, oh my God. Like, you know, when you are tired and you maybe, like, just lay down for a couple of minutes, you instantly kind of fall asleep. That's what this mattress does. Like, oh my God, it's the best thing in the world. And you're just like, like, yes. After a long day of either recording, taking your dog out, going out shopping, whatever, with your parent, or with your mom, dad, whoever, or doing something, and you just come home, you jump on that bed, and you just lay in the bed. Oh my God. So good. But maybe I might move my stuff around one day. Because I kind of want to... I'm like, as much as I like my bed right here, I kind of want to move it where my TV is. And then my TV where my bed is. Perfect. Mm-hmm. What you about to do? Are you about to pull on him? Oh no! You mean Princess Shino follow you meanie? That's what you got. Gotcha. Shall we make it a third? You can't ignore her. She's cute. She's your Hestia and eats. It was very effective. Domo, arigato. Honestly, it's not. I mean, well, what else can you do? You guys are gonna fail this as well. I just know it. Excuse me. Well, yeah, because you are a princess. You're supposed to approve and deny things. Oh, they got her in her cute outfit. Oh, my God. Yeah, it's fine. She got this. Oh my God. That's his baby. He loved her so much. And she's probably going to finish it within a week. That's easy. I mean, at least they're giving her something else to do. Where'd you go? Holy shit! Ah, okay. Well, that's her in work mode. You know, when we are in work mode, we gotta get this shit done so we don't worry about it, we don't stress about it, and... You wrote the same thing over and over again! Princess, that's cheating! Oh, okay, when I get you. Yeah, it is messed up. No, you guys. It's not that hard. You know, if you put your all into it, you can get a lot of things done in one day or in a week. Sleepy time. Good job, baby. Once again, Demon King, you have failed! I mean, you could give her twice as much the next time, but I think honestly she'll finish it.
super duper quickly.
Yeah. They still think you like baby. Like under 10. Is this your final quest for the episode? But we're also, you're gonna fail this as well, guys. Why are we even trying? Like, no. I think so. Maybe you should just let them go. That's hell. Yeah, you're really important, unlike them. Ma'am, is this another Detective Conan reference? That's just cute. Yeah. See, that's not Cheeto anymore. It's Itsuki. That's good, Itsuki. It would have been really extra funny if she used her CL voice from Kitty Kitty Pretty Girl Mo, but I don't think she would have had time to. Not really. Me now. So fucking cute. Oh my god. Stop it. This was a freaking damn good episode. Oh my god. But to see the Demon King and, you know, his crew have quests. Because I kind of was wondering if that ever really truly was going to happen in this series. But thank you for giving me this. I need this show to get a season 2, even though we're not done with it yet. I would love to just see what happens with the princess. But something tells me, just like with other typical mangas, it depends on how far the manga is and if the anime has caught up with the manga, possibly. And I won't really know until, like, I watch the last 2 episodes to see where, and then plus I want to read the manga as well. But hearing her use her other voices for characters, I can't. Like, oh my god. Yes, it would have been nice to hear my child, my best girl freaking CL, cure parfait, but no, of course, you gotta give me my Hestia, my Itsuki. Almost a week after Quintessential ended, but yes, best girl gave me 2 other best girls in 1 episode today. And that's a win in my book. You give me best girls, like, just a voice. But honestly, did the Demon King really think she was going to fail anything? I mean, come on. This is freaking best girl Chino, Itsuki, Hestia, CL. When she wants to do something, she gets it done. And that's one of the many things of, like, any character. Freaking Shiva from, not Shiva, Shia? Shia, I think that's how you pronounce her name, from Kuma Kuma Bear. Whatever she wants, any character that she kind of plays, she's just like, we're gonna get this done, we're gonna get it done now. I love the fact that they gave her homework and she got it done in a day, because that reminds me of, like, when I was in school, and this is also the mentality that I even have now. I'm the type of person where it's like, let me get this stuff done now so that I don't have to worry about it later. I don't have to stress about it. So, giving an example, I remember one time I had a project to do. And I told my teacher, I was like, if I can get this done by the end of the week, can I turn it into you by Friday? And my teacher was like, there's no way in heck that you can get this done. And I was like, oh, like, really? Bet. Watch me. And stuff. Because I love proving people wrong, like, no matter what. That's just something I like to do. Because I'm like, no, yeah, there's no way in hell you can get this done. And I got it done. And by Friday afternoon, I was like, here you go. Here's my project. And everybody else was looking at me like, you're already done? I was like, yeah, I'm already done. So during that break, I had nothing else to do because I got all my stuff done. And I had friends come up to me like, oh my god, like, Khadija, like, can you help me with this? Can you help me with that? And I was like, yeah, I'll help you get started, but you still have to do the rest of the work because it wouldn't be fair if I did all your work and you did nothing because, oh my god, that's not how the world works all the time. You have to do something just as much as I did something myself. But, like, yeah, I mean, seriously, that's one of the mentalities that I'm probably going to end up teaching my kids as well whenever I do have kids because it's better to get it done, like, ASAP so that you don't have to worry about it and stress about it. Plus, the fact is, you know, it's the way of my upbringing, of how my parents raised me, and how, if I did, like, got a bad grade or anything, I'm not only hard on myself, but my parents are hard on me, and it's like that, and stuff. So, I mean, but it's not, like, a bad thing, because some people will say it is a bad thing, but it's just, you know, the way you're taught and stuff. Some people are very lazy about it. Some people are very, like, passionate about their work and what they want to do to get done. But yeah, I think it was a really interesting job to give her homework, or really essentially work, because I mean, she is a princess, so she has to approve or deny a lot of things besides her mom. So if her mom doesn't do it for a day, it automatically kind of falls in her hands, and so she has to worry about a lot of things just as much as her mom, but it seems like her mom has to handle a lot more stuff than her, but you know, we'll never know. So hopefully, here's hoping, we are almost done with this show, that we get to see her mom. I just want to see what her mom looks like. Like, oh my god, yes, hearing my favorite VA up in the show as her mom is awesome, but not seeing her mom is not cool. Every single time when we see something of her mother, it is the back of her head. I would like to see the front of her, please, because I know if freaking if the princess is pretty, then the mom has to be pretty as well. I mean, come on, this is Saudi hiring son. Of course she plays a pretty character. Like, oh my god, let me just see her, please, like, and fangirl, because that's all I want. Like, oh my god. But go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 10. Okay, episode 10 in 3, 2, 1, go. Well, what is it? She looks so adorable. Yeah. You about to run to the human room? Girl, hold up. You, no, princess. You not about to run all the way from the team. I mean, because it seemed like she is, because she got a sports gear on. She like, let me stretch it out for a second. I'm ready to go. Ready to take a nice little long ass drag. Girl, stop. Yeah, just give her a couple hours. She'll be fine. She got jerky. I guess so. We've only really seen her in a dress. And then her work clothes dress. But she was kind of saying she was gonna come back. I mean, it's not like she's like, yeah, I'm gonna escape and I'm never coming back. Girl is running like a bat out of hell, damn. This child, too damn smart. You are up against a pretty cure, sir. I mean, honestly, did you guys think you could defeat a pretty cure? Do you know who she is? Bed trap. Like she's gonna fall for that. Oh my god. Honey, you were doing so well. Because remember, they don't deliver to the demon castle. But, okay, hold on, wait. Guys, you know she doesn't act like the typical hostage, so she's okay. So then can you go for her? Or have the girl that looks like her, you know, go to the human realm or some shit. Could be like a date. I mean, like, cause she is of age, right? But you guys are friends, kinda. You can't say no to her. Night night. If they didn't stop her, she would have got it by now. That's a good question. Yeah. I mean, don't you guys have, like, a spell that would turn you guys into humans for, like, an episode? She looks so cute. Yeah. Ooh, the moon. Yeah, you look good. But still, your horns. Yeah. What the? You idiots! I mean, damn, they could have just waited outside the kingdom. Oh, banana milk flavored. That sounds good. I mean, we at Disneyland, because god dang. The caramel one sounds good, but that banana milk too. Popcorn. Yeah, it's good, ain't it? The donut. Oh, sweet buns. It's not actually gonna kill you. Yeah, he's still eating it. That's so cute. Right? What you smell? Remnants? You want more? That's the newer and better one, ain't it? Ooh, speed settings. Oh my god, and a timer. Princess, you better hurry. That's what I want. No, that one now sucks. Yeah, I mean, come on. honestly, we can compare this. You know any Pretty Cure series? And when they come out with the new thing and you want the DX version that has everything? Yes, even though it's a little probably more expensive. We want that. We'll get her the damn pillow. Mm-hmm. Are they even somewhat close? Like, damn. 4 hours? You guys are in two different lines. What the heck? Uh-huh. You do that. Uh-huh. A little sleepy, too. Mm-hmm. You gotta be ready for it. And besides, you're almost close. You're almost next. Okay, get the money out. Princess! Did you fall asleep? Get the money! Oh shit, she slept. Okay, get the money out of her pocket. Something, I don't know! Oh, shit. Damn. So. Maybe it's a festival. Festival. Mm-hmm. Ah, you have a good sleep, babe. This is truly Disneyland. Except there's no rides. Girl, already got some food again. Oh. Oh. Good job. Hey, free food. The popcorn. Oh, she's going to sleep. Oh my god, if I had a pillow like that. Oh! Huh? What's up? Oh, it is. Oh, poor baby. Yeah. Plus, there's so much sound and noise and everything. You ain't gonna be able to sleep with that. Oh, baby. What? Oh my god, stop. That was so cute. Well, hey, at least you got a pillow. Yeah, I know. Arigato. Yeah! It felt like Disney World for an episode because she got food. I mean, hey, she didn't ride no rides. It would have been interesting if they like on a roller coaster with her or something. I don't know. That would have been freaking hilarious. Oh my god. This was so good. To see her go out and about. I mean, hell, to start this episode where she was like, yes, I have gym clothes on. I'm about to run out of this bitch. My determined child was like, Let's go. We gotta get it. All of this for a pillow. And then, you know, the DX, the better, more upgraded version comes out. And she's like, you know what? I don't want that other one. I don't want that one. Like, probably more expensive, which of course. But yes, she got to have something that she really, truly wanted. Like I said, going back to Pretty Care, honestly, you know, anytime when the new, like, magical girl item for Pretty Care comes out, the transformation item, the wands, they always have the regular version and then the DX version, and I only have one, and that's from Kitty Kitty Pretty Girl Mode, aka the season she was a part of, and I don't have her little, her thing, but I paid $30, almost $40 for it and such, but I do want to collect the freaking one from the season so bad, because I want it, and it's so pretty, and it looks just like it, like, ah! Honestly, it was a cute date. Yeah. It was just like her and her three dads. Honestly, because it was so freaking cute. Like, oh my god. But all of that for a pillow. A nice, high quality pillow. Troubling dreams. I mean, okay, so then we might have an episode where, yeah, the Demon King and everyone might go in her dreams for an episode. It might be like that one episode of the Demon Girl Next Door. Honestly, I would love to see that because, like, as someone who really loved the crap out of the Demon Girl Next Door and honestly cannot wait into season two, that episode where Shamiko went inside of Momo's dreams. Fucking hilarious. She'd be like, what the fuck are we about to do? And the things that she encountered, you'd be like, girl, really? But this was so cute for her to hang out with her three dads, technically, and go to a neighboring kingdom to get a pillow, then to get a different pillow because she's like, oh, hey, you know, the nice, the nicer, pretty, more expensive pillow, because, you know, hey, we gotta do that-ish. And to her, like, them watching fireworks together, oh my god, like, stop it. Like, you gave me feels to any other show that her and the Demon Lord freaking VAs are in together, so stop it. Like, I can't. Like, it's too much. Like, honestly, that was all the freaking Belle Hestia ships and the freaking Futado and Isuki ships. Like, that's too much for me. I can't. And, you know, I can't imagine if she was in the next season of Sword. Can you imagine if she was in the next season of Sword Art Online? Oh my god. Like, no. That's too much shipping. Like, I can't. Oh my god. But if she was, I'd be like, no, I can't ship you with Kirito because he belongs to Asuna. No one else but her. And oh my god. Don't do it, please. I swear to God. You already have Miss Belle and Hestia and Futada and Itsuki, even though I don't know if Futada and Itsuki are endgame, which I really would like them to be. But, you know, we just gotta wait and see. But yeah, like a cute little date episode with her and her three dads. So fucking adorable. But in the end, she got the pillow. I mean, she was using it a little bit for herself, but then, you know, she's like, hey, the teddy bear demons want to try it, and they just look so cute with it. Oh my god, like, they've been lighting up for multiple days. And the fact that the demon lord honestly went into a different line, oh my god, I can't. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 9 and 10 of The Sleeping Princess in the Demon's Castle. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Mattress Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys officially all next Wednesday for the finale. Bye, guys.